Okay, I'll be real with you. These don't offer the latest in airsoft tech. They aren't that last missing piece to your loadout, and in case you were wondering, they don't even shoot. At the same time though, it's pretty rare that our staff at the store will universally agree that any new product is cool, but these little guns left a big first impression. Chances are, if you've searched up anything gun related on the internet, the powers of targeted advertisement means you've more than likely heard of goat gun replicas. Now there's no way around it, these replicas aren't cheap, but they're also not the G.I. Joe accessories that you might remember from the 90s. These are every bit a high quality simulation and not the cheap, flimsy, plasticky toys you might expect. Just like the replicas in our airsoft world aren't the cheap department store airsoft guns that a newer player to airsoft might expect. So in many ways, I might actually expect the airsoft community to warm up quite well to these because, I mean, we get it. It doesn't have to be a real gun in order to be a lot of fun just sitting on your desk. Even without picking one up, I can't help but think there's just something about obsessively accurate, scaled down versions of real life objects. They really went the extra mile for realism. I love that the controls actually have a different finish than the rest of the gun, and it just looks so good. Now, I'm sure there's a cliche statement somewhere about awakening your inner child, but the truth is, there's model cars for racing fans, model airplanes for aviation guys, so I think it's about time somebody stepped up to the plate for firearms. Now these of course aren't just for display, these are very much designed to be fiddled around with. And I do feel like if I put one of these guns in front of any of you guys, you'd be hard pressed not to pick one up. And you'll probably be pretty glad you did. See, you'll be surprised just like all of us were at the sheer mass of these little goat guns because they are fully constructed of metal. Take for instance this M4, which comes in at 360 grams, which is almost double the weight of a standard smartphone. Now what this all means is it does a surprisingly good job of fooling my brain into thinking this is actually what a scaled down AR really would feel like, because this is what the scale weight of an AR would be. In the hands, that illusion just scratches an itch for me. It's hard to explain. Now, as I mentioned before, these are really more of a simulation rather than a toy. Now, what do I mean by that? They could have easily made these out of plastic and it would have looked just as good sitting on your desk, and they could have called it a day, charged a whole lot less for them as well. But they chose to make these completely out of metal, not just for that realistic weight that I was talking about, but it gives you a nice tactile function as well. These were thoughtfully designed to be as realistic as reasonably possible, which means that you don't just yank out the magazine, you actually depress this tiny little mag release and yank out your mag that way. And I gotta say, it's surprisingly addictive just to shove that magazine back into the gun. The slide on the 1911 doesn't just slide back and forth, it actually has a little recoil spring and slide catch so it locks back on empty. As a huge 1911 fan myself, I was just so impressed that all the controls actually work, like the safety and even the beaver tail safety, which is just something I did not expect. Fresh from the box, these replicas come in a few pieces and only requires a couple of minutes to assemble. There are included instructions in the box and video tutorials off of the Goat Guns website. All included hardware as well as a mini screwdriver is also included. It's worth noting that the 1911 in particular is a slightly different scale than the 1/3 rifles. My best guess would be roughly half scale, which is somewhat of a downer for the scale collector, but this does mean that they could more easily fit in all those functions into this tiny little 1911. Each model comes with little dummy rounds that you can actually load into a spring-loaded metal magazine, which is just a nice touch. And of course, if you want to get specific extra rounds for any caliber that they offer, they are available as well. These little dummy shells are actually turned from a solid piece of brass, and boy do they just look so good peeking out of that ejection port. The newest MCX model actually chambers and ejects rounds as well, which is just so cool to see in action. Is it necessary? Nope, but I am really glad they did it. Which leads me to one of my favorite things about GO guns. They didn't just release the gun and call it a day. They actually released an entire line of accessories just so you can customize and build your gun exactly the way you like it. It's almost like they actually understand the firearms community. We got everything from sights to vertical grips to an entire M203 launcher complete with 40mm shell. They are all made of metal as well, so it does add a bit more mass to the gun. It is a little bit odd to see something like an angled foregrip being made of metal, but it is nice to see that the accessories are just as high quality and substantial as the rest of the lineup. I have a feeling that GOAT Guns will definitely release a whole lot more accessories down the road so you can really replicate that niche dream build of yours. I'm lucky enough to work in an industry where fiddling around with guns is largely considered a normal workday, but I can't imagine too many HR departments being happy with you bringing your airsoft gun to fiddle around with at your desk. It sounds silly, but something like this can do a surprisingly good job of scratching that itch while you're on break at work. And the best part is, these are not intimidating. You can show this to a curious coworker who wants to know more about guns, and you can actually show them, for the most part, how they load, function, and operate, and that's pretty cool. So do I think that you should be adding one of these lovely little GOAT guns to your shopping cart? Well, if you're trying to get your airsoft loadout off the ground, then naturally, there are a whole lot more important things that you should be looking at. However, if you've been looking for something exactly like this, and like me, have just been constantly disappointed, then rest assured that these are definitely the next level in replica miniature firearms. For me personally, I gotta say, these are absolutely worth the price of admission. The care and engineering that went into designing something like this is just exactly what we're looking for coming out of airsoft companies, and I always say I support innovation. Even though this is an entirely different segment from the sport that we know and love, these are just too cool to ignore. What do you guys think? Let us know in the comments how you feel about GOAT guns. Instagram fad or something cool that's here to stay? All right, thanks so much for watching. If you like this video, don't forget to subscribe, and I'll catch you on the next one.